Major retailers like Walmart and Target are cutting prices in order to attract more consumers, even as inflation appears to be easing. But are these price cuts really going to be enough for those struggling to make ends meet? Joining me now to talk a little bit.
Well, you know, it might be enough for people who live outside of New York, but inside New York, where half of families struggle to pay their rent, minor discounts might not be enough. And stores like this may keep losing customers as the people who walk by just can't afford to go inside and buy what they used to. And that means, at least in New York, more stores like this are going to close.
With inflation on the rise and more Americans paying attention to what they're spending, Target has a new strategy to help you shop more.
It's totally different than it was 4 years ago.
Everything is high, everything.
There's no getting around the sinking feeling that a trip to the grocery store or a retail giant like Target will cost you significantly more today than it did just a few years ago.
The feature of this is people are grumbling about high prices, but they keep paying them. And now people are like, okay, you know what? Enough's enough.
While they say that they're doing it to ease the impact of inflation, is that really the case?
No, I don't feel the change. No.
But if prices are dropping, it could be more about the company's bottom line and marketing rather than their morals.
But there are concerns the move could hurt small businesses struggling to compete with larger chains on price.
It's kind of the Amazon effect. You've got this big player that can afford to cut prices and do all this thing, and they can afford to pay their workers more. Small businesses can't.
When I look at the list of what the price reductions were at stores like Target, for instance, I mean, they weren't huge. It was like 50 cents off a pack of Goldfish.
So after bankrupting middle America with sky-high prices, our corporate overlords have decided to give our wallets a break. But even though most people rightfully blame these big chains as being greedy, what nobody's talking about is that they're just passing costs along to us that this greedy city of New York is passing along to them. That's why these high prices ain't going away anytime soon. Certainly, there's no excuse for $18 deodorant, but there's also no excuse for rampant retail theft, which the city refuses to punish, which pushes up prices as stores jack them up to cover their losses, while they pay extra for things like security guards, cameras, and progressive plexiglass to lock up our products because we won't lock up our criminals. And another thing nobody's talking about is that the costs for a store like this to exist in New York City are higher than anybody imagines. New York mandates some of the highest labor costs anywhere in the country. Plus, there are out-of-control utility costs here, including a new tax on water. But then, there's the rents. And the real reason these chains are working over their customer base with prices that nobody can afford is because crime here is so bad, with vacant storefronts creating ghost towns all over the city, that what landlords are doing is they're raising the rents on the stores that are still in operation to make up for their losses. Does that sound familiar? Which means New York City is engaged in a massive money grab at all levels, creating a sort of race to the bottom where every element of society tries to take as much as it can on the backs of middle-class residents all before the entire system breaks down. And that's why even though discount retailers are dropping their prices across the country, it might not be enough to save them here in New York from shutting down completely. So here we are inside Target, the former king of discount chains, and they better do something quick because last year they closed one New York City store and reports indicate that might happen again if they're unable to bring down their prices and bring back their customer base. Because if your customers aren't in the store, why bother keeping it open?
Everything is more expensive and everyone of every income bracket is feeling the pinch.
It's totally different than it was 4 years ago.
Now Target is hoping that in giving you a price break, you'll show your loyalty by continuing to choose them over other big box counterparts.
We heard from Walmart late last year that they're...
So what we're witnessing here at Target and pretty much everywhere is the exact same thing we're seeing in the fast food market right now. And that's fierce competition over the dollars in consumers' pockets. The problem is brands are realizing people are just running out of money. And just like McDonald's is bringing back its value menu to try and bring back its customer base, Target's got a new plan to do the exact same thing with everyday items that we might need to buy every day, which is an omission that their slogan, expect more, pay less, actually might mean expect nothing, pay extra. But that's about to change because somebody with a psychology degree must have told Target that the more we customers roam the aisles filling up our shopping carts, the more we trick ourselves into feeling like we're getting the deal of a lifetime, especially when everything seems like it's on sale, and the more likely we are to spend greater and greater amounts of money, which I think they call the Costco effect. Either way, it works. But while it looks like Target might be trying to bring down their prices and help us, critics say something much more sinister is at play here.
Everything from produce to paper
towels, dairy to diapers will be on markdown. Of the 5,000 everyday items slated for a price break, nothing will be more than 10 bucks. The catch is it'll change constantly.
In the past 4 years.
Oh, great. So what we're going to end up seeing here is revolving discounts. 1 week it'll be this athlete's foot cream, the next week it'll be this one. Which could be the result of artificial intelligence controlling our lives, forcing us to buy things we might not have come here for. All while at the exact same time helping a store like this turn a profit. More of a profit than it was turning in the past. But the marketing here is spot on. 5,000 everyday items for $10 or less? If that sounds specifically like the kind of thing designed to get you back into a store, that's because it is. And I'm not saying that lower prices on basic stuff is a bad thing. But from the store's perspective, maybe they're not selling enough no-name brand toilet paper for $11 four-pack. Also, when you look at how narrow these paper towel rolls are here, maybe shrinkflation is how they're gonna come up with these discounts. This is a roll of Bounty by comparison. This is like 3 of those. But even if Target does employ a little retail witchcraft to bring their prices down, observers are already saying that the types of sales we're seeing aren't really a discount, they're more of a slap in the face.
Now, whether people are really seeing the savings is still undecided. When I look at the list of what the price reductions were at stores like Target, for instance, I mean, they weren't huge. It was like 50 cents off a pack of Goldfish.
Paul Oster, CEO of Better Qualified.
So the analysts have spoken. They're saying that Target's discount aren't really going to save us that much money. For example, buy one, get one 25% off. You've got to buy 2 of these, and when you buy the second one, you save a little over $1. And how much is a discount really worth if the item is overpriced to begin with? Analysts are saying that these aren't really discounts. Instead, we're looking at bait-and-switch marketing to get us into these stores. Now, to be fair, Target is not the only company that's been doing this. In fact, Walgreens, CVS, pretty much every other chain like this, they're all trying to give us discount fever to an extent. But that's the thing. You have to buy 3 of these boxes of Band-Aids in order to get one free, and the prices are already so high that it doesn't really seem like it's going to save me any money. But saving money is something these big chains better figure out pretty quick, especially here in New York, because stores of this magnitude aren't exactly cheap real estate, especially in the most expensive city for renting anything in America. On top of that, it's not just products that are up. Everything's up. Produce is up. Big Chicken's charging an arm and a leg for what they got. And to be fair, customers here pay an arm and a leg in rent and living costs as well. Their utility bills are just as high as the stores, which could mean all these discounts we keep here about will be too little, too late.
Target's attempting to stay on top at a time when consumers are waving the white flag. Although inflation is easing, the strain isn't. According to the Federal Reserve Bank of New York, households just aren't spending what they used to.
Even when you go to
You know, it's crazy how pretty much every industry is fighting over the same dollar. Fast food is doing the same thing. Taco Bell, all these stores, they're bringing down their prices to try and get customers back. Stuff that you buy at the grocery store is about to get cheaper. But it might not matter because, as NBC New York recently reported, you need to make at least $135,000 a year to live comfortably in this city. Meanwhile, everywhere else in America, you're doing just fine on that salary. But in New York, you're choosing between keeping the lights on and Frank's Red Hot. But since stores and customers are both getting squeezed by the exact same system, stores are asking themselves, what do we discount so that people will come back? And people are saying to themselves, do I even need to buy this in the first place? But the reason that's a problem is because for the last 4 years, chains like Target have restructured their business because we were all buying way too much. And that's why prices have just been going up and up and up. But now Target's kind of in a catch-22 because their costs for buying their inventory have gone through the roof, and customers are starting to say, no, I don't need $24 dish soap. Yet the costs to operate the store that sells the overpriced detergent, those are up too. So what do they do? If they make this too cheap, the store's not going to make any money, and if they keep raising it, nobody's going to buy it. It's going to stay on the shelf. But even though Target might be the focus of a lot of this recent research, they're not the only chain experiencing problems. In fact, Walgreens has actually been closing more stores in New York recently than Target has. And they're not alone. It doesn't really matter where you go in this city. Anywhere, you're gonna find empty storefronts, and ghost towns like this one are popping up in neighborhoods that used to be very vibrant. Right now, we're in Chelsea, 7th Avenue, 14th Street. And you've literally got swaths of empty flagship retail. And not only is it no longer possible to find clothing stores, jewelry stores, boutiques in this neighborhood, you won't find too many drug stores over here either, because they're closing too. Not just because of the insane costs of operating a store in a neighborhood like this. Critics say there are other reasons, many of which are self-inflicted, for why these places can just no longer survive.
The problem Target has faced is they've been left out of the party. They are seen by many of their consumers as becoming expensive. Today, consumers are necessarily focused on pricing. So the action that...
So the unfortunate truth here is that all these chains that are shutting down, shipping out, they got drunk off of free money. And empty storefronts, this is the hangover period.
Because the money's not running around this city like it used to be. And the problem for many of these retailers is that since their new method of warfare is to battle each other with discounts,
what we're essentially watching play out is a race to the bottom where the first winner is actually the first loser. And what's going to happen here is there's going to be downward pressure on prices. There has to be. We need these discounts because customers are done and they're going to be going to the cheapest stores they can possibly find. But this puts a place like Target in a very weird position along with Walgreens and CVS. None of these places are affordable anymore. They're all super expensive. And it's hard to look at the items you see on a shelf without feeling like you're getting scammed. And the problem for all of these places, not just Target, is that they revolve around an in-store shopping experience. But sadly, as you're about to see, the in-store experience might be going the way of the dinosaurs.
Well, they don't operate in a vacuum, and so as Target has announced lowering thousands of items in price, their competition, notably, for example, Walmart, Amazon, and Costco, are not sitting on their hands. And so this is a bit of a foot race to outpace the lingering effect of inflation, which of course...
So the battle over people's hearts, minds, souls, wallets, it doesn't just take place in a physical store.
Which puts chains that have a physical store presence as their core component in a tough spot. Because although their in-store shopping experience might beat what you find online, there aren't too many physical retail chains that have a website that's worth anything. In fact, most of them are downright terrible.
And that's a problem because customers are trying to save money and they're going to be looking everywhere for the best discounts they can find. Oftentimes, they find them online. Amazon, eBay, those websites are also way better at getting people to go through the psychology of buying multiple things than a store like this's website will ever be.
But the funny thing is that these big chains do save money because they buy more products than, say, a smaller store.
Yet those smaller stores, they put them out of business a long time ago. Your independent New York chains, those are long gone. And now, because of fierce online competition, the same thing is happening to discount retailers like Target.
That race to cut prices might sound great to people's ears, but would that have an effect on those smaller stores that don't have that kind of flexibility that a larger store might have?
This is undoubtedly an unfair issue. It will smaller stores.
You know, it's so interesting to see the same thing happening to these mega chains that they did to everybody else.
Because just as tiny local retailers who couldn't operate at the scale of a place like a Walmart ended up closing because their prices were too high and all their customers left, now these same flagships stores are headed in the exact same direction and the customers are on the internet.
Literally, look, you have an empty storefront here and upstairs you have an apartment building. All these people, they're on their computers buying stuff that's getting delivered. They're not downstairs at the store anymore. And as all that extra money and profit and business rolls into these online marketplaces, they're going to get all the growth and all the pain is going to happen right here at the local level.
And the reality is that these stores, CVS, Walgreens, Target, they're not going to win a race to the bottom against a bottom feeding company like Amazon that's been happy down there for a lot longer than any of us care to remember.
Now look, that's not a dig at Amazon. We're just entering a world where people like you and me, I mean, I'm already buying pretty much everything on Amazon. I don't care where I buy it.
Not to mention the online shopping experience isn't met with disruptions like what you'll find in a physical store where everything's locked up behind progressive plexiglass because if it's not locked up, it's gonna get stolen. How long are you gonna wait for a manager? 5 minutes? 10 minutes? 20 minutes? That's gonna vary from store to store. Yet all of these same items are available online within 24 hours without any of the hassle or any of the disruptions to your day. And observers say this is gonna lead to a new round of disruption for brick and mortar retail.
One which some speculate they may never bounce back from, especially in crime-ridden parts of the country like New York. Part in the story where the world as we know it could really change. Because 45,000 stores could close because of e-commerce. Which means any disruption we thought that was already putting companies out of business is about to get 10 times worse.
And this strategy of announcing that everyday items are now going to be on sale, what are those everyday items? You don't even know until you show up at a store and waste your time. You know what's going to happen? People are going to go to these stores, they're going to see the discount tags on the aisles, but no products because all that stuff's going to be sold out.
And to an extent, the world has moved past bait and switch marketing tactics. Like if you go to a store and the thing you want screws you over, you're just going to go online next time. You're not going to waste your time twice.
That frustrating, disgusting experience is literally not something that can happen on Amazon. You know the price of everything right away. Now, does Amazon love its customers as much as the YMCA does? No, absolutely not. But they and many online retailers have such a compelling offering, it doesn't matter. Customer money is on the way.
And you know what this means? We're going to see more and more money go to the internet and less money go to these physical storefronts. And as these close down, the other side
side, the scale as you will, it's gonna keep tipping. Amazon's gonna get better. They're gonna get faster. You're gonna get your stuff sooner, and there will be less of these places to compete with them. They could probably scale up immediately by hiring an army of e-bike delivery riders to get things to people within a half an hour. But there's actually another reason why we might be about to see even more closed storefronts. And that's because historically, once prices go up, they tend to stay that way. They might level off for a while, but they just go up and up and up and up, and there's nothing we can do about it. And that's gonna lead customers to continue doing two things as the economy continues to stay tough. And the first and most obvious of those is that since people have less money because things are tough, they've now got less time. Maybe they're working a second job. Maybe they're putting in extra hours if they have the ability to get them. Maybe they're doing something like Uber or Lyft on the weekends to try and make those rent payments. It's very sad, but it's reality. And if people have less time, wasting it inside of a store that's got fake discounts and isn't really saving you money isn't going to be an option for them. And since they've got less time and also less money by proxy, they're just going to get pickier and pickier on where they spend and what they spend their money on. And when you combine all that with the fundamental difference in shopping experiences, you've got a recipe for more store closures, and there's nothing these chains can do about it. Definitely, we're in an environment where 30-cent discounts aren't gonna stop the waves of change. And just look at the inside of this store. Every aisle is locked up on both sides. All this anti-shoplifting technology is costing these places money too. Yet that's not a problem Amazon suffers with either. And how long can these physical retailers even survive like this if this is how they're operating, especially in a city like New York? All of these taxes and hidden fees that come from crime and the hidden fees and taxes we have in general are gonna take their toll. And it's absolutely crazy that in a city with so much foot traffic, physical stores are dying out faster here than anywhere else. Is that what's happening? Is New York City shutting down its mega retail chains, forcing them out by bad policies in an environment that they just cannot operate in with stiff competition for people's dollars that comes from the internet? Or are the problems these businesses are having, are they self-inflicted? Did they get too greedy? Are they just trying to price gouge us? Or are these high prices the result of a catch-22 they cannot avoid even if they try? Let me know what you think. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.